I'm going to be demonstrating how to initiate a piggyback solution onto the IV that I initiated in the last video. So I'm going to do that by following the six rites of medication administration, which are rite, patient, dose, route, time, medication, and documentation. I'm going to check three times before I actually administer the medication, that I have the right patient, dose, medication. So my orders are to administer Clofarin, 560 milligrams IV piggyback every 8 hours. I have my reconstituted bottle, which is 500 milligrams per milliliter. So after doing the math, that would be 1.12 milliliters that I need to draw up and put it into my 50 milliliters of normal saline. And then for my piggyback infusion, it's a drop factor of 10, 68 milliliters an hour, and 11 drops per minute. So I've identified this as the correct patient medication. I'm going to prepare my medication, perform hand hygiene. Going to clean the top of this with alcohol. I'm going to insert it right into that port. I'm going to recap that, the one-handed technique, dispose of that in my sharps container. Then I'm going to open my secondary IV kit. Maybe. Close this for just a second. I am going to label the piggyback solution the same way I did my normal saline, which was the patient name, start time, completion time, flow rate, my initials. Going to put on clean gloves. I'm going to make sure that this roller clamp is closed. I'm going to remove the cap from the piggyback port on the spike. I'm going to make sure the grip chamber is filled up about halfway. Pry the this part with alcohol. Going to attach. Going to open this. Going to recheck my infusion rate. Which is 11 drops. Or yeah, 11 drops. Check it. I'm going to make sure that they're both infusing right. I'm going to label the tubing for the piggyback. Same way I did the tubing on my primary tubing. Started it, the day it should be changed. I'm going to check my IV site, ask the patient how they're doing, document everything I did.